Okay, good morning or afternoon, depending on when you're watching this video. All right, today is the Wednesday, right in the middle here. So it's going to be week two. So it's Monday, Tuesday. So it should be at the bottom of your bell work. Math fees, remember, I'm going to come around in the middle of class. Please remind me to collect that $5. Okay, I may collect today and tomorrow. We'll see. But I want to try to collect from everyone, okay? All right, look here. Lost stuff in the front of the room. If you look up at the front whiteboard, it looks like two calculators and some lip gloss. All right, all homework is due. Let's see, all homework is due the next day. But I reserve the right to pick it up the next day, but usually I'll pick it up on Friday. So if you don't finish, you do have extra time. So make sure you go online and get that work. Okay, look here. I want you to name these diagrams. This one is a ray. So for A, you can name it as ray AB. You can name it as ray AC. You cannot name it as ray BC. So BC would only be from here to here. That would not be the whole ray. So you got to start at A, which is called the what point? Does anybody know what this point's called? It's called the end point. It's at the end. So don't miss that. This one right here goes backwards, but it starts at the B. So the answer for that one, B, will be ray. Notice the arrow's going in the same direction as the other one, but it's going to be ray BA. Okay? The last one is a plane, so you could say plane Q, that fancy letter with no dot, or you can use three crooked ones. So I'm going to say X, Z, P. So plane X, Z, P. You cannot say plane X, Y, Z. Do you know why? Well, you can't say X, Y, Z because that's collinear. It has to be three non-collinear points. All right, we learned distance formulas yesterday, so let's take a look at that. Well, to do the distance formula, it doesn't matter which one you start with. And I think I tried to show that yesterday. Like, you might call this point 2, I might call this point 2, but I'll go backwards. So label it XY, XY. That might help you. Put your X's together. So it's negative 5 and negative 2. And then it's negative 8 and negative 7. This gives you a double negative, so that gives you negative 3 squared. Now, one thing I want to point out to you, a negative 3 squared is a positive 9. On your calculator, if you press negative 3 squared, it's only going to square the 3, and you're going to end up with a negative 9. But if you put negative 3 with parentheses squared, it not only squares the 3, but it squares the negative, and that's what you want to do. Okay, so there's a difference between these two. This becomes a plus. That gives you a negative 1 squared. And a negative 1 squared is 1 times 1 is 1. Don't put 2, okay? So the answer I get is the square root of 10, and hopefully you get that as well. 3 times 3 is 9, so it's 3 point something. The square root of 9 is 3, and this is a little bit more. So it's probably like 3.1 or something. Okay, that takes care of the distance formula. Remember, you're going to have a little quiz this Friday. Plus, we're getting books on Friday. When you get your book, I want you to take it home with you. All right, let's try one more distance formula on a new sheet of paper. Okay, try that one. So let me go ahead and do it. We're going to work backwards. So it's going to be negative 2 and negative 5, and then negative 7 and 8. This right here becomes a plus, so 5 minus 2 is 3 squared. This right here becomes a negative 15 squared, which I think is 225. So it's going to be 9 plus 225, whatever that is. So it looks like 234. So the square root of 234. And you can use your calculator on that. Since I'm already in it, let me go ahead and do that. So on your calculator, you're going to press, or mine, You're going to press 234 shift square root. You should get 15.3. Make sure you can do that on your calculator. All calculators are a little different. If you need some help, maybe let me know and I'll get over there. All right, translation. Take down these notes, copy that down. We had this in 1.2, but I didn't really talk to you about it, so I need to teach it to you now. A translation is sliding an object, okay? So if you take something and slide it, it is called a translation. For example, if I take this clothespin like that, and I want to slide it 2 units to the right, that would move the X. If I want to slide it 2 units down, that would change the Y. If I want to move it 2 units to the right and 2 units down, I would take it here, move it this way, and then move it that way. That would be the translation. Okay? This is called the image, and the original one is called the pre-image. All right, in any event, let's take a look at this one. We're going to translate this one 2 units up and 4 units down. Okay, so 2 units up. If you're going to go 2 units up, that's going to move the Y. Up and down moves the Y. So put a +2 on the Y. Okay, remember X, Y. This is 4 units down. Actually, that's kind of conflicting here. We're going to say 2 units up and 4 units to the right. Okay, actually, I'm doing both of these on one operation. So let's do both. So we want to go 2 units up, so that's a +2 on the Y, and then 4 units to the right, that's going to move the X, so you want to put a +4 right here. So that's going to end up with a new point, and that new point is going to be a +2, because 4 minus 2, and this one's going to be 9. So the pre-image is -2, 1, 2, up 7. I'm running out of room there. And then the image is going to be over 2, up 9, somewhere up here. And again, I don't have room. But the bottom line here is this. When you translate, all you're doing is sliding it. So if you go 2 units to the right or left, that's going to change the X. If you go up or down, that's going to change the Y. All right, here's your assignment for today. Took me about 7 minutes to go over that. Actually, no, I still need to go with midpoint. Sorry about that. Now, this is 1.3. Midpoint's easy. So copy down everything you see right there and try to locate where these points are. Okay, this point is start at the origin. So it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's a -5 because I'm going left, and then 1, 2, I'm going up 2. This one is 1, 2, 3 to the right, and then down 2 is a negative. All right, I have my 2 points. To get the midpoint, which is probably somewhere right there, which is halfway, midpoint, you're going to add up the x's. So take the x's, which are here. So you're going to take -5 + 3 / 2, because you're going to always split it in half, halfway. And then you're going to add up the y's. So you're going to get 2 minus or plus a -2, which gives you 0, of course. So you're going to end up with a -2/2 and 0. So you're going to go -1/0. So -1/0, I missed it a little bit. That should be the midpoint. You can see my line is a little crooked. And a midpoint is also called a segment bisector. All right, let me let you try one before I get you to actually do the work. I want you to find the midpoint of these 2 points, okay? So I'm going to say 5 and 8 and 2 and -10. So find the midpoint. Add up your x's, divide by 2, add up your y's, and divide by 2. Well, if you add these up, you get 7, and if you add these up, you get a -2. So the midpoint is going to be 3.5. And -1. That's the midpoint. Well, let's check it to make sure. So you're going to go over 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I kind of had to squeeze that a little bit. Okay, that's point A. We'll call this one point B. So over 2, down 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, and this one is going to be point B. This one is point A. So the midpoint should be half of that, which is over 3.5. So that's 3.5 about right there, and then down 1. Pretty close. And that is called a segment bisector. Okay, so today's work is easy. Midpoint, you just add up the x's, divide by 2, add up the y's, and divide by 2. Here's your work. I do want you to do the translations first. Make sure you draw the diagram. Remember, if you move left or right, you only change the x. This one is midpoint. All right, all your work is due Friday, and I'm going to put this on the board right now. Have a good morning, 11 minutes.